Good afternoon and welcome to St. Jane Francis de Chantal. We especially welcome any guests and visitors who are joining us for the celebration of the third Sunday of Advent. We ask that you keep in mind the special intentions for which this Mass is offered, including Carol Trinity Miller, Herbert Depps, Isabel McLaughlin, Loretta Shadden, the Bauer family members, Giuseppe Stocchetti, Josephine Manley, Julie Voyas, and Valentine Vatsai. Our gathering song this evening is number 395. O come, Emmanuel, 395. Please rise.
They will see the glory of the Lord, the splendor of our God. that are feeble. Make firm the knees that are weak. Say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication, with divine recompense. He comes to save you. Then the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag, then the tongue of the mute will sing. Those whom the Lord has ransomed will return and enter Zion singing, crowned with everlasting joy. They will meet with joy and gladness. Sorrow and mourning will flee. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. One question I'm frequently asked, Father, I need patience. But Father, I pray for patience and it just doesn't come. And my response to them is, don't pray for patience because God may test your patience. Rather, pray for understanding. That opens up a whole new realm of the situation you might find yourself in. It may not be patience you need. It may be a greater understanding of what this is all about. Today the church celebrates Gaudete Sunday, Rejoice Sunday, because we are nearer to Christmas than we were on the first week of Advent. We are nearer to Christmas. And the questions that are posed in the gospel are questions that are posed to us. What do you want to see? What do you want to see? What did you go out to see? As we prepare in this Advent season, we prepare to see the Christ child. We prepare to see him born again into the world. As we celebrate this Eucharist, as we celebrate this day, may we indeed reflect upon those two questions. One, what did you go out to see? And two, as we hear in the latter part of today's gospel, who did you go out to see? John the Baptizer plays a prominent role, but he knows his role. He is not the Christ, he is the precursor of Christ. He is the one who makes it known, as we hear in the last part of today's gospel. John is the messenger of Jesus. He is not Jesus. He is the messenger of Jesus. We do indeed are messengers of Jesus. We are disciples of the Lord. So as we prepare to indeed draw ever closer to the great feast of Christmas, may we reflect upon that question today's earlier part of today's gospel. Who did you go out to see? Who did you go out to see? May the answer be, we went to see the Christ, the Son of the living God. In one voice, we profess our one faith. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For our sin and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory, to living and dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who is Jesus, the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord of God, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism and forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen.
We place our needs and our petitions, and indeed our thanksgivings in the hands of the loving Father.
That Christ may form church leaders into prophets and messengers to prepare his way. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord, our judge, may bring vindication and divine recompense for the oppressed of our world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Jesus may bless the joy and gladness all experiencing sorrow and mourning this holiday season. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this Eucharistic community may be granted the gifts of wisdom and fortitude. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may be crowned with everlasting joy by our Lord in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With thanksgivings for your many blessings, bring to the altar the intentions of this Mass, those in our prayer box and website, and those in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious, loving God, you know our hearts and our prayers long before we voice them. In your love and in your mercy, may they be granted through you, we ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
While the gifts are prepared, let us sing number 418 on Jordan's Bank, 418.
Thank you.
Pray, my friend, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all of the church.
May the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, be offered to you unceasingly, to complete what was begun in the sacred mystery, and powerfully accomplish for us your saving work, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and true God. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him, with a love beyond all telling. John the Baptizer sang his praises and made it known when at last he came. It is by his gift that we already rejoice in the mystery of his nativity, so that when he comes, he'll find us watchful in prayer, in our hearts with wonder, praise, and awe. And so with all the angels, we praise you in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Through him and with him and in him,
O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of the church. In grace, and grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign.
Union Stones, 4-2-0.
Thank you.
Gracious, loving God, you call us to the one table. You partake of the one bread and the one cup, so as we become the one body of Christ and Church. May we become the mystery you celebrate, and we ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Family breakfast with St. Nick will be tomorrow morning at 9:45 a.m. The giving tree deadline is tomorrow, December 11th. The family pizza and sing-along will be next Friday, December 16th. Deadline for signing up is Monday, December 12th. St. Jane Francis Advent Reconciliation Service will be Monday, December 12th at 6 o'clock. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is number 409, People Look East.